Good morning. Today I would like to discuss with you about the history of trademarks, intellectual properties. See, actually what happens, even the big kings used to upbraid the businessmen, the sailors, because they have access to other nations, influence over other countries' kings. Therefore, the king thought that these sailors or these businessmen may influence the other countries to dethrone him. These businessmen and salesmen used to store money and a lot of valuables. Therefore, they are called as guberas. Earlier, all stories are being written only on the basis of sailing, inventing new countries, other things, finding new creatures, inhabitants, etc. The earlier, whenever the country occupies other countries, they used to steal, recover, store the valuables available, which gives some information. And there was books, there was no printing of books, the other scriptures are being stored. Later on, after what had happened, when there was a threat of black magic and other things, the orthodox kings who occupies the countries in which magics are performed used to destroy the libraries. And particularly, after formation of so many Muslim countries, whenever they invade other countries, they used to destroy it. This way, this is what had happened. During medieval period, black reign of Europe countries, there was no movement from one country to other countries. And the necessities are being managed to supply and store only for their country people. But when industrial revolution started, only England produced huge fabrics. So that time they want that this excess fabric should be sold to other countries. That time only the king used to give a letter that is called letter patent. That letter patent was used as copyright. So this is the history. Even the East India Company, comprised of 30 persons, were permitted to trade India by a letter patent. That's why they say it is letter patent, I quote, chartered, I quote, etc., etc. Forget about that. Coming to the chapter, copyright is prima facie organ of the intellectual property. Even if you did not register your copyright, you can claim copyrights. That is why there are two different claim as a copyright word and other trademarks, other intellectual properties are. Number one, a registered owner, other one is user claim. Under that circumstances, even if you did not register, you have copyright. Thereafter, trademark, design, patent, geographical indication marks, and individual performance. So many things now intellectual properties are introduced. Here, Anton Pollen search warrant. Anton Pollen search warrants are being issued. If anybody's infringement of intellectual property is something different. Passing off intellectual property is crime, because knowingly that a renowned product is sold, you are manufacturing the same and duplicating it. Infringement is you do not know whether he has got registered or not, but you simply follow your trademark, similar to that. That all are the cases. For time being, I will complete this once with a simple judgment, where in Karnataka High Court, AIR 2021, 72, held that Matru Ayurveda, that was the plaintiff trademark. Then defendant used Matru Veda. The Matru Ayurveda is having a symbol of leaves, but Matru Ayurveda used to keep some circle stating of Ayurveda written in styled manner. So they say it is not deceptively similar, and injunction was not granted. Kindly go through this. Best wishes.